And they call a timeout with 45.9 seconds left.
It's not over, folks. Fat lady hadn't sung. Her vocal cords are warm, but she hadn't sung yet.
It is a 49-yard field goal attempt by an All-American kicker, Alan Kane, who did miss three last week. I would love for him to miss his first one tonight right now with 45 seconds left. Here we go. The snap. The place. It's kick. The snap is high. The kick is long, and it is no good. Kick is no good. And the Cats, Nathan, with 41.5 seconds left, have some life. They will get the ball where? Let's see.
At the 32-yard line.
At the 32.
Got to score a touchdown. 68 yards away, 41.5 seconds.
All right, back to pass. Three receivers right now. They come out to the left side to Gallion. Gallion up to the 40, out of bounds at the 42-yard line. 31 seconds left. LC trails by six. They are a touchdown away from tying, potentially tying, and an extra point from winning. Two receivers right and left for Bunning. He looks near side. Now he's looking back over the middle. Got a man complete. That's DeMario, and they stop the clock to move the chains. Quickly get your team up. You're at the Bulldog 47. At the Bulldog 47, 22.7 seconds left.
Replays. 2 seconds,
but
they're all outside play.
No timeouts. LC, Bunning, two receivers both sides. Back to pass. Looks over the middle. Got a man. That's Parker. Completed the 30. Parker down to the 27. Stop the clock with 16.9 seconds left. LC will quickly get in place. The chain crew is running down the field. Locks it with 14.9 seconds left. LC now at the 27. Oh my, heartbeat still. Bunning back to pass. He's got time. Looking. Got a man over the middle. That's Gallion at the 10. Gallion at the 5. Gallion out of bounds at the 3. Or at the 5, rather. 7.2 seconds left.
Wow.
First and goal at the 6. 7.2 seconds left. You don't have a lot of time, but you're at the 6. LC trails by six. Quickly looking. Time looking. Got a man back corner out of the end zone. Incomplete pass. 3.6 seconds left. He was looking for Cortland Bell, and he threw it where only Bell could catch it. Now you're looking at potentially the last play of the game, barring a penalty. 3.6 seconds left.
I don't think anybody's sitting down anywhere.
Bunning calls for the football. Here we go, last play of the game. Bunning, looking, got a man.
Touchdown Wildcats!
Improvement in each of the guys that's been working hard, and just everybody just getting bigger, faster, stronger. Just the sky's the limit for us this year.
We was just ready. We was cocky coming into the season, and we felt like we couldn't be beat. Couldn't nobody beat us.
Ride, it feels good. It feels good.
We're just hungry. We're just hungry. You can look in the eyes and you can see it. 7-3 for 4 years straight is not a good feeling. And if you just look into your teammates' eyes, you look into your brother's eyes, you see you got that dedication and that drive this year. Really been working hard in the weight room, and it's really gonna pay off come fall.
We changed it up a little bit this year. We went to this thing called the Hatch System. It's similar to what LSU and Alabama, they do in their off-season programs. It's been nothing but great. It's all power and speed movements. and it's gonna really, we're gonna really pop when we come out on the football field.
Make sure you work every rep, accelerating every rep, working your hand swing. Let's go, baby. Right.
Ty just went and kind of hung around Gale Hatch and became his puppy for several weeks, and now as a, you know, it's Gale Hatch really thinks a lot of Ty Webb as a young coach, and Ty made it his own. I'm telling you, he took us to another level.
And let's work every rep, every rep. We gonna win today.
I got it from a high school program that came and practiced at our facility, and the coach had a t-shirt on and said, "Win today." I said, "Coach, tell me about that." And he began to share, you know, what that meant. And I said, "Man, that makes sense." So it wasn't original, I stole it. And you know, it became our own. Of course, I called him, I said, "Man, we adopted the win today." He said, "Well, I stole it too, Coach." Everything we get in coaching, you know, not much is original.
It's like life, you know. Football, you got to win on that field today. They were trying to do, take it to life. You got to do the right thing. That's basically winning, you know. It all fall in together, like life and football. It's telling you, life and football kind of tie in a little bit.
And we just push each other and push each other and push each other. And it was that win today attitude. And I knew then that we had the best offseason we'd ever had before, which is going to lead to the best season coming in.
Look back on last season, what happened, you know, and it just kind of motivated us, you know, to come in and try to do our best, you know, play our best.
To win today is, that's something that not just football, but in the classrooms and in the dorms and whatever we were doing, we were going to win today. Because, I mean, I played some pretty serious video games where win today, sure, you know, I had to look down and really check my character and pull off fourth quarter victories and some Madden, you know, but.
First and foremost, we brothers, guys.
You don't work, you don't.
Brothers on three, 1, 2, 3,
brothers.
Guys, make sure.
Cortland Bell, how are you? How was your trip?
Yes.
You're not a freshman.
Red tote that on you.
Let's go.
Senior class coming into this year, we was ready to hit the ground running. Regardless, we were prepared for anything because we know what we had. We had a goal to reach and we were trying to get to. So we was excited just to even see each other and get everything going.
Right now, getting unpacked, get ready. It's not gonna be easy. But it's gonna be worth it, okay?
You got comfort and looks.
You mind my take?
Why would you get this? What are you gonna do with this?
First original chest I ever came out.
Epic fails right now. Epic fails.
Game time.
Right now, we're going to do a lot of NCAA information.
You are going to be the championship team. This is the year of the Cats. This is the year that has been put together for several years in a row, and this is a year it all comes together.
This here, fried chicken, you know what I'm saying? Mashed potatoes, got some corn over here, you know what I'm saying? Some screen beans, put the brown gravy over there.
LC Wildcat, throw it up on Pop.
Let me throw it up.
Just brought. I got the wrong hand.
This is my 29th off-season, or 29th fall camp. I still wonder what I'm doing the times during fall camp. And I want to go home and call Mom. So that's three core values. Number one, do what's right, work as hard as you possibly can. Number three, treat others like you want to be treated.
The egos have to get dropped right now. I mean, all the seniors, everybody stand up for the seniors. Hey, we put a lot of work, man. This is our last go around.
God, this is the start. Lord, I thank you for the beginning. And let us have a love for one another that only you could cause to happen. I pray blessing. I pray safety, protection over each player. In Christ's name, amen.
Spell it out! Spell it out! Spell it out! Ready? Exercise.
Hey! Y'all alone! Set! Go! Go! Drill! 14! 18! Supposed to be easy. You gotta drop, drop, drop.
Come on, Graham. Don't quit on me, son.
Go, ball flex.
Go. Oh, you gotta be tough. You gotta just blank out and not think about anything else but finishing and not quitting on your teammate.
Formation recognition. We have flex four and Okie four. That's it. Okay, real simple. Watch the guys in front of you. Get the mental reps. If you don't know, ask questions.
We knew we wanted somebody who understood the culture, and really there wasn't a backup plan. I mean, Brian Wallace was a guy we wanted from day one. We never even talked to anybody else, and it worked out. And really, JC, it was JC's idea. So, I mean, the thing fit like a glove, and it just worked. There was no ego, there was no jockeying for position, and to watch them honor one another.
It was, when I found out Coach Buck was gone, you know, it hurt me the most, because he was like a father figure to me. Coach Buck, I love him, but Coach Wallace, he came in and he did everything, even with, you know, Coach Charles being playing here, Coach Charles knew us as players. But I feel like Coach Wallace came in as he not knowing everybody personally, and he coached us.
So the transition wasn't hard. It was, do you really want to learn it? And do you really want to be a part of this team? Because if you griped and moaned about a change, then I feel like you're being selfish. So everybody took it in stride in the spring. You learned it, got in the playbook. I think this year was the first year that everyone got in their playbooks and actually like understood what the scheme of the defense was.
I feel like I kind of had a connection with him. You know, I didn't know, he was a white shirt until, you know, a couple weeks later that he'd actually played here and been through it. So, I mean, I just felt like, you know, we had something in common from the very get-go. And, I mean, his attitude is a lot like, you know, a lot of our attitudes. Just as players going to get the ball, we kind of took that from him and messed our own intensity with his, so it helped out a lot having him around.
And then we found out he's a white shirt. I was like, dang, that's why he act like that. You know, he came in hollering, you know, and like, you know, like this is his family, you know, and he got on us and things like that. We bonded with him really quick.
Teams, you know what they did on us last year? They ran the football. 155 yards a game we gave up rushing. That's unacceptable. We got the number two team in the country coming to our house for our home game.
Yeah.
We got Mary Hart and Baylor. We're going to do.
Yeah.
They're running the football on us. We're going to have six points. Every team we play.
Let's go.
6-point explosion. You got 3
points. Number 8, baby.
You're getting out. Next man, baby. Ready to roll, baby. Let's go.
Let them go, go.
Go, guys, go, guys, go, guys!
As I talked to Coach Dunn in the exit interview last, I guess, during the spring, and I told him straight up, I mean, whatever it takes to win. I mean, it's not about stats. It's not, because obviously I'm not going to play in the NFL or anything like that. I just want to, I wanted to be known as a winner and as a competitor and someone that wouldn't quit whenever times got rough.
God dang it, Jamie!
And I feel like I showed that as the season progressed. And I mean, I felt like the attitude, not necessarily for me, but that I let out towards everybody around me. I mean, they saw that I wasn't going to quit, even whenever times were tough.
At the end of last season, Coach Dunner pulled me in there and told me, you know, I had a real good chance of, you know, taking over playing if I just, you know, steadily kept getting better and learning the information, you know. And so I was going in there feeling very confident, you know. I felt very confident, felt like I had a real good camp, and just things didn't seem to work out the way that I thought they would.
But then Jamie has a breakout spring. He probably has the best spring he left no doubt in spring ball that he was the guy, that he was gonna fix this.
We gotta be mentally focused, okay? Especially at this position. Y'all go shower up, have a good dinner, and I'll see y'all at 7:30 in the weight room.
Let's go. Q's on three. One, two, three. Q's.
Like, it was, like, unreal, you know. I had, you know, just seen him, you know, the last week, you know. And here, that, you know, he had died, you know, that really touched it, you know, it hurt it. So. And that was an unfortunate loss for us, you know, because you played a big role in our receiver group this year.
It was crazy for me with Zay, man. I was my roommate last spring, man. When I heard, it was just like, I just seen him. So it was like, on us, like, that was somebody missing that, like, that was one of our best receivers, you know? Like, it was just, like, that was one of our missing links. That's how I feel. And it was like not a practice, a game, a day, not even one day that went by, man, where I was just like, man, Zay. Like, Zay should have been here to see this. They should have been here to just been here, you know? But.
Pastor Lawrence Weatherby grew up in New Orleans, and so a lot of you guys will relate to him, and he'll relate to you. My question to you, do you know where you're going to be tomorrow if your tomorrow was canceled tonight? Where would you spend eternity if you received the breaking news that your tomorrow was canceled? It's not about the ice, it's not about the cars, it's not about the girls, it's not about the jewelry, it's not about none of that stuff, brothers. The issue here is about eternal life. Who would have thought Isaiah would not be here tonight? We assumed it because we're young, we're strong, we're vibrant, we're energy. We assume we're gonna make it. But you don't know when God's gonna punch your card. So if you want to guarantee that your eternity is right with God, and you never confess with your mouth, believe in your heart, I just need you to do a simple thing for me right now. Be ready to receive it. And let's just stand on your feet.
I mean, that was a big step in my life. Like, I kind of took that night as like I felt saved, you know? I mean, after that, I don't know really how to explain it. Just, I feel like God kind of took over in my life.
God wants to move in your heart. You know what I'm saying? I think God's starting to really put it together. Like, you're not going to be perfect in the actions that you're going to go about. You're going to go through trials. You're going to face storms. But when you accept Christ into your heart, you have that assurance that this is not the end, you know what I mean? And like, I think that was a night to where a lot of people start to understand what Christ wants to do in your life, because it was just amazing to be a part of that very moment. And I'm pretty sure a lot of guys, even like Nate, they will look back to that as one of the defining moments, not only in football, but in life.
For this game, you did. You feel me?
Yeah!
Oh, yeah!
Let's go! Let's go! Palms up, Big Twist! Palms up, Big Twist! Let's get it loose, 7-9. Get it loose, baby! Your right leg, double kick to the right leg.
All right, stay on them nonstop. It's gonna be a battle every play, but it's a battle we gotta win. You win enough battles, guess what? You win the war.
They don't have the seniors in their program that have invested like you guys have to come to this point for such a time as this and have the opportunity that this team, with its own destiny and own identity, has the opportunity to do. What does that mean for you today? Here's what it means. You win today.
Us as a defense, we've been doing this for 4 years, man. We've been together too long to come here and start this today. There ain't nobody running the ball on us, period. I'm challenging everybody to get it up out here, play hard as you can. If you're tired, we got, hey, I trust everybody we got on the side to come in and do the same thing the starter can do.
I just took a commercial break.
Good job, Darren. Come on, man.
You won today. That's all that matters.
Dominique, a.k.a. 15 Graham, you dig? You about to come out here. Hand these blazes, you feel me? They got us in the tent.
Hey, bro, we gotta show these people. Yo. Show the whole nation who he is. Let's go, baby. Body bags on three. 1, 2, 3.
Body bags!
Let's go. I trip right, Peter. Smash. Hit it, baby.
It's on us.
The Heavenly Father, we come to you now as your humble servant, Lord. Give you the utmost praise and thanks, Lord, for this victory tonight.
It's kind of one of those places in the program where this can be a marquee kind of deal. This game won't make us or break us. You hear me? And that needs to be our approach. This game will not make us break. Well, I think we approach practice the same way. We ain't gonna make a big deal about who's coming to town. It's gonna be a business week.
Great day. It's a great day.
This is what we live for right here. This is why we do what we do. Nice like these.
Who do you think you are? As a man thinks in his heart, so is he. Stay together. Strength and honor. I promise you, and we'll be better after this. You hear me? We're going to be better. Father, thank you for who you are. Lord, you're the strength of our lives, in victory and in defeat. Lord, let us learn it.
And then we get into the year, and, you know, he made some critical mistakes in early ball games that he had kind of reverted back to some of his old habits, and that created the, and I did that by design to see if it could, if we could get Jamie's attention.
All right, man, listen to me. Can't throw picks. You hear me? That's everybody. We ain't throwing picks. Throw completions. That's the rule. Quarterbacks, do not throw picks.
They just made it worse for themselves today.
Have fun with it, man. Have fun.
Certainly went into, you know, the Howard Payne game with thinking I was going to play, and then he did. He came in the second half, had an outstanding second half.
Coming at you.
Me had earned the right to be the starter against ETBU, and I went in totally open-minded. If he really took the ball and ran with it at that point, that he could have been the guy. I didn't have any, you know, I was pulling for Jamie. I really was. I was, because nobody had sacrificed more than Jamie Bunning. Nobody had put the work in that Jamie Bunning had put in. So I was hoping Jamie would get it done, but still, you know, results at the end of the day, win.
As a competitor, it was probably one of the toughest things I've ever been through. I mean, I haven't had a rough life as some of the people on the team, and I haven't really, I guess you could say, fought for much in my life, but But there's things I take pride in, and my competitiveness and the want to play and to prove everybody that I can do it no matter how tall I am or how small I may be to you. And I mean, once I got benched, it clicked that nerve in my brain and in my body to where, like, after that, I was just like, I'm not taking this, and we're not losing any more of these games. We're going out there, and every game's gonna have my 100% best effort, and I'm not gonna quit. You know, I got everybody's back on this team, and if they wanted to go into a fight, let's go. I mean, that's the mentality I took it as. I didn't take it as a, well, there goes my spot. You know what I'm saying? I fought for it every single day, and I eventually earned it back.
And you know, if you're not getting the results, then you got to make a change. And so I was open to that, and I was very open to Tim taking it the rest of the way and doing it. But you know, we got in the UTPU game, and you know, Tim, you know, struggled. And he just struggled the first half, and that's why we made the decision to go back with Jamie. Jamie probably had his best half of football, you know, and then went on the rest of the year, and I thought played extremely well.
I mean, yeah, there's some things that you agree with, you don't agree with, but we came out with a win that game, you know, and that was a big rivalry for us, and I feel like it kind of boosted us, you know, made us start clicking, you know, and that's the only thing that matters, you know, so.
Do we love each other? We love each other, we keep fighting, we keep getting better. Brett, good job. Came off the bench, did a great job. Hey, let's keep getting better. You keep getting better. You understand? You guys make each other better. I promise you, you do. Keep doing that, okay? Proud of you. That's a great win, man. That's a great win. Great win.
Good job, fellas.
Let's go. Q's on three. 1, 2, 3.
Q's.
I honestly don't think you can ever learn how to deal with it. You got to learn how to ignore it and how to fight through those words. And because during the game you got people telling you you suck, you know you're horrible, you're too small. Not that Coach Dunn's ever said that, but he's more of a constructive criticism type of guy. And sometimes the way he criticizes you can be harsh.
Why do you want to be a dumb butt?
He won't cuss you, and he won't do anything like that, but he can beat you with his words if you let him.
That one, that just that, his look, like when he's talking to you, he always looking at you, like in his eyes, like he looking like a little Chucky at you, like his eyes. Be like, dang, Coach, man. It ain't like, I ain't want to look in his eyes, but it was just like, he got a little light blue eyes, and he'd be like, I don't want to look him in his eyes. Not right now, anyway.
One of the guys that looks through you.
Yeah, like right through you. And he be, give me your eyes, boy. All right, you got him.
Everybody's talking about his number 2 versus number 21. At 11 o'clock, that 2 drops, that 21 drops. It don't matter. We got to line up and play. They got to line up and play. It does not matter. 2-21, that crap's all out the window. Anybody got anything they want to say? You seen anything y'all want to say?
What I noticed in every game they played, they never played to the end. Every game we played, we was in the game to the end. They never fought for 4 quarters. They never did. They never fought for 4 quarters. They're on the sideline. We play every game for 4 quarters. Every game. Cal, you sit on the sideline yet? You sit on the sideline yet, Shaq? Grant, you sit on the sideline yet? Richie, you sit on the sideline yet? They sit on the sideline. We never sit on the sideline. We never did. 4 quarters we've been fighting, dog. 4 quarters we've been fighting for 5 games. So the advantage we got against them, they haven't fought yet. They haven't. They haven't fought for 4 quarters yet.
They've been sitting on the sideline for two quarters, resting. Are we still grinding and fighting, having fun? You understand what I'm saying? So all that stuff about they number one and all this two in the nation, out the window at 11 o'clock. Because I guarantee you I got y'all back. At any point, just ride with me. Ride with me. And I guarantee you, it's going to be a fight. Oh, that's all I got to say, dog. It's been on my heart for 2 days. Just ride with me, dog. I got your back. And I guarantee you this. 11 brothers, we gonna fight all day. That's all I gotta say, bro.
Remember who you are. Loving brothers can't be beat. You remember that.
Here's what you can do. You can win four and get in the playoffs.
I hate that trip, man. I went my sophomore year and we had to do that trip. Man, I hated that trip. And I don't never want to go out here no more. And I thought we was going to fly, because somebody said we either going to fly to Sub Ross or Florida. So I was happy thinking we was going to fly. It ain't going to work like that.
You know what I'm saying? Straight in it.
So Wayne, how do you think of what you think about the game tomorrow?
We going to whoop them, boy.
What are your prediction on the score?
We going to whoop them, boy.
What are your prediction on the score?
We going to whoop them, boy.
Gotta flip a switch. You gotta flip a switch right now.
We love the Pinkies, but I don't care if you're number one in the nation. Our team is number one in the nation, dude. Let's shut them up. Y'all ready? Spot it out! Spot it out! Spot it out!
This is a heck of a win and puts us in position. Guys, we're playing a week at a time for the playoffs. You understand me?
Yes, sir.
And it's going, hey, it's going to be a battle. It's going to be a battle every week. You hear me?
That's the fun, man.
Let's go. I trips right, H move, gap kick. I trips right, H move, gap kick.
Just about every day in defense, you kick her butt. But today, offense, you won.
Yeah.
I don't know if I've ever seen a team that hungry. You were so hungry, and I'm so proud of you. I can't say enough. Corlin, that's huge, man. That's God honor.
Damn, I hate these push-ups.
You like that?
Yeah.
He laying on his knuckles.
Bomb. Bomb.
What's up with them knuckles?
Bomb. Bomb. Bomb.
Let's go, man. Look, go on and go home on three. One, two, three.
Go on and go home.
That was a
I said the jury was still out on whether this team's ready to extend its season. I think you're ready.
Yeah,
I believe you're ready. Let me tell you something. You're in for the fight of your life. You're in for the fight of your life. You know that. It's going to be preparation, preparation, preparation.
Hey, we're going to the ship, baby. You ain't never heard that before? We're going to the ship. For real, we got about 5-6 more weeks. Hey, we're going to play after the championship. That's how cold we about to be. It about to be snowing and everything. Hey, LC, baby, all the way to the top.
I just want you to know, I got my penny. And I got it right here.
We all blessed to do it one more time, baby. Let's go. Here you go.
What? Father God, bless our worship today. In Jesus' name, we love you, we bless you, we honor you. In Christ's name, amen.
Amen. Amen. All right. Let's do it.
Captain,
I'm from Louisiana.
Make left.
Yeah.
Hey, big-time players make big-time plays.
Yeah, I already know one thing. Leave it all out here, bro.
All right.
And we gonna do it.
Martin,
it's your dog. You gotta be leashed.
We finna whoop these boys. Finna whoop them boys. Boy, look scared, man.
Well, my main thoughts are going to be all positive. You know, like I said, you know, this place right here, it's a special place. You know, the school, everybody here is just wonderful. You know, everybody, people are wonderful, you know. And I find it as a blessing, you know, being a part of something like this. And I always look back on it as that, you know.
Just to be remembered is going to mean a lot to me. You know what I'm saying? People died every day. You can forget people. There's people that played in the program that people that forgot in the past time. But if you can remember me 10 to 15 years from now, that means I did my job to leave a legacy. I tell you what, I will say this. If my name don't remember, you don't know that I was on the first 80-win team and the first team to take LC to the playoff.
Oh, man. Legacy. The legacy we left, the teammates, the coaching, the parents, the fans. It's so much to remember, I can't even say, but the brotherhood, it's just crazy. I won't forget Louisiana College, I can tell you that. Every home game, I'll be here for sure. But it's just so much to just reflect on.
Opportunity. That word, it takes on a whole different meaning when I think about it, because coming from nothing and then making something out of nothing, the opportunity began once I stepped on Louisiana College campus in Pineville, Louisiana on August 14, 2009. You know, it changed. You know, and I'm appreciative for everything because that opportunity is leading me to where I'm at now, being a father, husband, and hopefully a professional football player, wherever that may be. But opportunity is the word that I will associate with Louisiana College.
I think the program, if you come here, you think you're coming to play football. You know, you think you're just going to play football and that's going to be it. But the coaches sew a lot into you, and they teach you how to be a man, not only on the field but off the field. Take care of your business off the field, and it'll carry over, you know. So I think the biggest thing for me is, you know, you think you're a man coming out of high school, but these coaches show you, you know, how to better yourself in every situation. And I really enjoyed the past 4 years playing for the coaches we got. It's unlike any place, you know. We got a special thing here, and that's why I really like it.
You're wondering, you're sitting there thinking like, man, this isn't what I signed up for. But, I mean, you stay all 4 years. I mean, you find out who you are. You find out, you know, the men that are coaches here. I mean, we all have great dads, no doubt. But when you're here, and because you're away from your parents so much, because you play football and you're with them so much, they're fathers away from our fathers. They treat you like they're your kids, and they treat you how a young man should be treated. And it's not, they don't baby us. They don't, like, okay, well, here, you did wrong, but, I mean, they're going to jump on you like your dad should, you know, and that's one of the things that I've learned is you find out who you are. You get put through so much stuff, and sometimes you get beaten to the point of pure exhaustion and just quitting. You just want to quit, and then for some reason, they just come talk to you, and you're like, man, I want to play for this guy. I want to do this for him.
All the coaches here, they do a great job. Of like just pulling you in and just saying, hey, you know what? You're here to play football, but you're also here to be a man and understand what life's about. And, you know, you got to appreciate that from a coach. I mean, because it's not LSU. You know, we're not at Alabama or LSU or Florida where they're making hundreds of thousands of dollars, you know. And, you know, they don't really care if you go to class or not. I'm like, no, you're going to class. You're going to get a degree here.
Just the pride that we have to as a team, you know, to be the first team to go 8-2, take a lot of pride in that.
It's over now. That's your college career. And, you know, when you look back at stuff like that, you just got to make sure that you gave 100% throughout your time here, because really, whenever it's all said and done, and it's really up to God whenever your time is over with, it's whether you gave 100% or not, that whether you regret your time or not, you know. It's did you buy in? Did you give it all on the field, you know? Did you play your last play the way you wanted to be played? You know, what was your legacy, basically?
Remember, you know, my brothers, you know, I'm gonna remember, it's like a brotherhood around here. Like, we all just
I remember, like, it's just, you know, I feel like I'm gonna be able to call anybody from here, even on the office side. Just not a white shirt thing. I feel like I got people. If I just need to call somebody, just need something, I just feel like I got them. I'm gonna feel like somebody always got my back. You know what I'm saying?
Just the brother aspect of everything, just everybody loving on each other, just always picking each other up. And just knowing, you know, at sometimes it's gonna be peaks and valleys of, you know, relationships and stuff like that. The same at the end of the day, you can always go to that person and be like, you know, they can help you out with something, and just dwell on the moment that you're at together. But yeah.
We're gonna keep pushing them, and I'm pretty sure guys will come back and tell them to do better than what we did. And one day this program will win a national championship.
I play football. Obviously, I know people ask me how was my degree and my, you know, school, and I'll tell them school was great. I enjoyed it, but you know, the main thing that I always remember and carry with me was, you know, the football experience and the brotherhood and the, you know, the bonds that I made as far as here. But whenever people ask me, what were you in college? I'll tell them white shirt, Wildcat, white shirt. So definitely football. Football was number one.
Mostly white shirt pride. I mean, we grind on that all the time, and like, it's just a prideful thing to have. Like, you don't understand it until you actually go through all the turmoil and get to finish as a senior and you're done, and then you can't explain it. You just got to finish it out and know what it's about.
LC's definitely given me the lifelong lessons of coming in a boy, leaving a man, in the sense of knowing what I'm going to do with my life after this, knowing how to get set up, keeping a good head on my shoulders, learning how to be a leader in the community, learning how to be a positive influence, working as hard as you possibly can, work ethic. I mean, all of those things play in from learning that here at LC through the coaching staff. I mean, they've given us a lot of lifelong lessons that we can take home or take home with us and keep forever.
Oh, man, it's just one thing, and it revolves around Coach Matchett. Just be accountable, hold people accountable that you love, and keep God first in your life.
Just buying the program, you know, and listen to your coaches. You know, they won't lead you wrong. Just basically buy in and just do what you got to do.
I think it's so unique at Louisiana College because the coaches care about you first as a person. They care about what you're doing in your personal life. They care about what you're doing with your social media. They care about the fact of, are you gonna be a good husband one day? Are you gonna make a difference in the community? They care about that kind of stuff. And it's hard to understand as a young man, but when you grow and you see that care is what will make you a better person, you appreciate it all the more, you know what I mean? And it took for me to buy in, to really understand what this brotherhood is all about. Because we don't have the attractions and everything everybody else has. We only have each other. And that just makes it all the more special.
Nothing was diminished in what really took place in 2012. You know, a lot of firsts. Obviously, the 8-win season and the first playoff in school history will forever be remembered. But more than that, the lives that were really changed forever in 2012, that the headlines never really will discuss, and never will be in print and in any newspaper. But I do believe that they were, a lot of the stories were told in heaven's headlines, and that a lot of eternal things happened in the 2012 season that really I'll reflect upon. It'll be the thing that probably as a papa made, you know, if I can use that term of papa of this thing, probably makes me the most proud that these boys really were able to see the deeper things about Louisiana College football and family that we became and that we are and will continue to be. You know, those guys, seniors, will forever be, you know, Louisiana College football family.
What I'm most proud about the program and what I did is that we did it for free. The hard work, it was all voluntary. No, we weren't no scholarship guys. You know, we weren't getting a free ride. We weren't getting a nice dorm, a Jerry Lane SUV or whatever the case. You know, we done this because we wanted to. We set out a goal and we were going to accomplish it, you know, whatever at whatever cost. And, you know, in 20 years, that's going to be something I'm going to be proud of. You know, deep down inside, you know, I didn't get to play at the big program, you know. But, you know, I did something that no other, you know, level does. We play for free. We did it because we wanted to, you know, not because we had to. You know, it was all voluntary 100%, and that's just something that, you know, you could take away and hold, you know, high on your shelf of accomplishments is just being a four-year player for a Division III school that, you know, was completely voluntary.
In a way, it was a good thing, man. It was a good thing, because when I was in Florida, man, I was just out there wilding, man. I wasn't doing nothing right. You know, like, I just came out of high school, you know. I mean, I'm from Florida, man, Jacksonville. It's a lot of people that just ain't got it. I can't say I don't, but I do. And at the same time, like, I'm glad I wasn't there. Like, in a way, I can't say that I'm glad, because I would want to be. Like, I would have wanted to stay and did 4 years in Florida, of course, you know. But being here is just, it's not a bad thing that I'm here. Like, everything I'm doing here, I'm finna get a degree. So it's like, good.
We did what no team ever done before. And so at the end of the day, we left it better than we found it, but we didn't leave the way we wanted to leave. But that's just leaving a legacy and letting the younger guys know that now you see where we messed up at. Now you raised the ball. You see where we our flaws is at. Now you do better than we did. And so that's how I look at it. That we leaving something for the young guys to know what to do and what not to do, so they can succeed better than we did. So I think that's all that matters.
They kind of like burned something in my heart. Like, I mean, I don't know what it is. I mean, going through like white shirt pride, yeah, sure, that's gonna stick around for a while. I got that white cloth, you know, but it's just a mentality. Like, they burn a mentality into you, like, to be a winner, to win today, and, you know, to be successful.
We can't see the benefits of it now, but we will when LC is holding up a national championship, and we'll be able to be like, he was waiting for that very exact moment. Maybe as a program, I'm telling you guys, trying to do something. It's something that we're missing right now. You know what I mean? And it's something that as a program, we're gonna have to, coaches, the future players are gonna still have to dig and grind it out. Who knows what it may be, but when we get to where we can, I guess, magnify his name on a national level, a real national level, like ESPN type level, because I guarantee you, like, whoever wins this championship this year will probably not, God will probably not be the first thing out their mouth, but I guarantee you when LC gets there, that's who the glory will go to, so the whole world can see it, not just a state or a city. But he's trying to, we're gonna impact this whole nation, for real. And I know it and I believe it. And I just know that's what's gonna happen when LC holds up that trophy.
Let us shine the light up.
giant rides, catch the demons by surprise. Sanctified.